Welcome to worship today. Where are you all? Come on, people who are down the back having a nice time, come in church and have a nice time. Because we're about to sing. We're about to sing a wonderful song about joy. So it's a good dancing sort of one. So you can get ready to get those hips wiggling and let's sing. Took a big deep breath before you sang that last verse because that was tricky, wasn't it? Okay, Steve, would you come and do the Advent wreath with these people, please?
Do you want to light the candles? Okay, last Sunday we lit the candle of peace. We light it and the candle of hope again. As we remember that Christ, who was born in Bethlehem, will come again to judge the world and bring it everlasting peace. The third candle of Advent is the candle of joy. When the angel Gabriel told Mary that a special child will be born to her, she was filled with joy. She sang a song that began with the words, "My soul magnifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour." Just as the birth of Jesus gave great joy to his mother, so his presence in the world gave joy to those who had none before. He healed them and gave them hope and peace when they believed in him. From hope, peace and love grows joy. So we light the candle of joy to remind us that when Jesus is born in us, as we have joy, and that through him there will be everlasting joy on earth. Joy is like a light shining in a dark place. And as we look at this candle, we celebrate the joy that we find in Jesus Christ. So say with me, thank you, God, for the joy you give us. We ask that as we wait for all your promises to come true and for Christ to come again, that you would remain present with us. Help us today and every day to worship you, to hear your word, and to do your will by sharing your joy with each other. We ask it in the name of the one who was born in Bethlehem. Amen.
And now, because that was the candle of joy, we're going to stand up again and sing another song about joy that probably is a little bit easier to sing for you. Joy to the World, and let's sing it with real joy.
Sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns, the men their songs employ. Well, fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, we beat the sounding joy.
Okay, please sit down. Today we're going to talk about John the Baptist. Hands up if you've heard of John the Baptist. Excellent. Okay, there's a very famous thing about John the Baptist. Before he was even born, he knew about Jesus and jumped for joy. Even when he was in his mummy's tummy, he jumped for joy, and that gave everybody a bit of a fright. But there we are. That's what John the Baptist did. But later on, we're going to hear another story about John the Baptist, how he sent to ask Jesus a question to say what that message there is. See, if Jesus and John the Baptist had mobile phones, they'd have probably texted with each other a lot. But here's what they would have texted. John would have texted to Jesus, "Are you the one?" And you've got that on your bag. So we're going to think some more about that and try and figure out for ourselves if Jesus really is the one sent by God to show us the way to go to him. But first of all, I have a question for you. I have an activity for you, in fact. It's about hope. Hope. I hope you've all got your goodie bag. Have you got your goodie bag? I hope you've all got your goodie bag, because I promise you that in your goodie bag are lots of good things. The first thing about it is I want to ask you, what is hope? Who knows what hope is? Hope, hope. Anyone? Hope? A volunteer?
Feeling optimistic that things are going to be good.
Okay, that's a good one for hope. Okay, anyone else got anything good about hope? Okay, so hope is like you wish something would happen and it does. You hope that it happens. So I hope you all have your goodie bag. All right, what's the difference if I say, what's a promise? What's a promise? Who knows what's a promise? Oh, there's a good answers in the front row. What's a promise? Promise is a hope. Is it?
Is it? Who can tell me a promise? What's a promise? It's sort of a hope. Something that's going to happen. It's definitely going to happen. I promise you there's good things in this goodie bag, which I now want you to open. In it, you'll find a Christmas decoration. Mine's got two of the three wise men on it. There'll also be a pen. You need that now. And you need the string. Okay, because we're going to make a decoration for our Christmas trees. Have you got a Christmas tree? Hands up if you've got a Christmas tree. Oh, yes, I've got a Christmas tree. Good. Well, here's a new decoration for it. You need to thread the string through the hole in the top of the Christmas decoration, tie it in a knot so it doesn't fall off, and on the back, on the non-pretty side of your Christmas decoration, write those words. It says, hang your hope on Jesus. And then you'll hang the decoration on your tree. But you'll hang your hope on Jesus. So, remembering that when you trust in Jesus and have him for your friend, things that you hope for will not be hopes at all. Because with Jesus, they will be true. Jesus will always be with you. So on the back of your... See now there, I've tied my string, so that's nice. I can wear it on my arm if I like, if I want to be a Christmas tree. But on the back there, right, hang your hope on Jesus. Well done. So put your pen back in your goodie bag so you know it's there for next time you need it. Sometimes we forget to hang our hope on Jesus and try and do things without him. Then things don't go so well. But let's now confess those times to God when we were disobedient, and he will forgive us. So let us affirm our trust in God's mercy and confess that we need forgiveness. Lord God, you made this world and made us in your own image. Forgive us when we turn away from you. Lord God, through your Son you overcame evil and death. Rescue us from slavery to sin. Lord God, by your Holy Spirit you restore us to fellowship with you and with one another. Breathe your love and freedom into our lives.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you your sins, and keep you in life eternal. Amen.
Now we're going to sing another song, another Christmas carol, Mary's Boy Child. So please stand and let's sing together.
Long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible say, Mary's boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. They see a bright new shining star and hear a choir sing. The music came from afar. Now Joseph and his wife Mary, they come to Bethlehem that night, but find no place to born the child. Not a single room was in. the stable so forlorn, and in a manger cold and dark, Mary's little boy was born. Hark now, hear the angels sing, listen to what they say, that man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
To talk today a bit about the push it onto the next slide, the difference between hope and promise. And we've talked a little bit about that already. We can always hope in Jesus and be certain that God keeps his promise. Do you always keep all your promises? Always?
I try.
Sometimes I don't do it real well. But God is fully reliable. He will always keep his promises. Head for your goodie bags again. In some of the goodie bags, not all, but some, mine doesn't have one, there's coloured pieces of paper. Has anyone got, Aaron's got one. There's some that are yellow and some that are orange. So what I'm going to do now, you didn't get any? Put up your hands if you've got them. Oh, yes, there's quite a lot. Okay, get ready to get on your feet then, folks, because let me just see which ones are which. Okay, the oranges. People who've got the oranges, not the lemons, but the oranges, need to come out one at a time because those are promises of God. So if you've got a promise, bring it out here. And I didn't have any blue tack, so we're going to use sticky tape. Okay, so here we've got a promise. God sent me to release from darkness the blind, God says in Isaiah. Okay, thank you. Joy's got one. It says, we will not be afraid even if the seas roar and rage. Put that up there. Thank you. He shall judge between the nations and shall arbitrate for many people. Oh, this is good. Here we've got another one. The lame will leap and dance. A shoot, we had this reading a couple of weeks ago. A shoot shall come out of the stump of Jesse. This one says, look, your king is coming to you. He is humble and rides on a donkey. I hope you're thinking about these. The deaf will hear. Excellent. Another one. God will send a prophet from among the people and I will tell him what to say. People with yellow, just know your turn's coming. Bethlehem, from you a ruler will come who will guide my people. I need one more piece of sticky tape here, Father. The messenger you long to see will come and proclaim my covenant. These are all things out of the Bible that God is speaking. I will use parables when I speak to them. There's another one. This one says, the Lord will be your everlasting light. Wow, this is getting full. The lame will leap and dance for joy. Okay, now, people with yellow,
All of these things come out of the Old Testament, and you can check the Bible verses if you like where they come from, because God made all the promises and they're all in that book that's there in your seats. The promises of God are contained in the Bible and you can read them for yourself. The other thing, this is the exciting part, the other thing that's in the Bible is how God kept those promises. God kept those promises through the things that are on the yellow pieces of paper. So I'll take the sticky tape, Steve, and people can come and see if you can match up. Oh, here's the hard one. I hope the people who got yellow are really good thinkers. See if you can match up the promise with the fulfillment of the promise. Think about it, guys. If you can't, maybe my thinking is a little esoteric. The deaf will hear,
and Jesus causes the deaf to hear and the dumb to speak.
Excellent. And here's Andrew's got one. It says, the Lord will be your everlasting light. And Andrew had I am the light of the world, says Jesus. Great, Matt, here's a sticker for you. Aaron's got one. I must preach the good news of the kingdom of God because that is what God sent me to do. Okay, Matthew's got one there, which says, a man got up, took up the bed he had been lying on, and went home praising God. So it was the man who couldn't walk, so the lame will dance for joy. Where is he? He's here. Stick him there. Thank you very much. All right, what have we got? Jesus heals a blind man. Jesus, God sent me to release from darkness the blind. Good-o. They're getting good on matching, aren't they? Bet they're good at memory games.
Oh, I haven't seen mine.
Jesus enters Jerusalem on a donkey. Look, your king is coming, and he rides on a donkey. Okay, Liam's got one here, which says, God has given the Son a full right to judge. All right, so it's going to have judge on it somewhere. Maybe they're not all out. Here's the one. Here it is. This one. So stick it next to that one. Let's see what Zoe's got. The words I have spoken to you will bring God's life-giving spirit. Wow, that's a good one. Parables. We'll hold on to that one. We'll see what else there is. There might be some that are missing. Jesus ordered the wind and the waves, and there was a great calm. So I think we'll put there, don't be afraid even when the winds and seas rage. Okay, Joy, have you got one?
Promise I'll try.
No, that's another, that's the next activity. Oh. You hang on to that one. Okay. While they were in Bethlehem, did we see there was a Bethlehem one? Yes, there's a Bethlehem one. Okay. Oh, they're good on matching. Jesus was a descendant of King David, who was Jesse's son. Jesse's up here at the top, there's one. In parables. Okay, Zoe got the hardest one. We'll have to work out what the end is. I'll use parables when I speak to you. Okay. I think, in fact, we've got them mixed up. Put that one there. I think this one here, I must preach the good news and do what God tells me. That will go up there. I will do what God tells me. And then your one comes here. The words I've spoken will bring God's life-giving spirit. Wow. So there's just 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12. 12 promises, and they're not just hope because they're real promises. God fulfilled the promises using those. There's lots and lots more. Lots and lots more in the Bible. And you might like for your homework. Do you need homework? You need homework for... School's over. Oh, sorry. Okay. Well, if you needed homework, you could always dig into the Bible and see if you can find... Oh, it's over there. See if you can find some other promises of God.
Okay, now I need to get my jigger because we've just done that and we just did that, and because I didn't click it on, never mind. That's great. You all did a really good job with those promises of God. God made lots of promises, and a lot of them, I'll just go back one slide, see if I can do that. I can. God made lots of promises, but a lot of them, and this is a useful thing to remember at Christmas time, a lot of them start with, don't be afraid, don't be scared. Oh, when I hear God say that, I know that something good's going to happen. Remember at Christmas time, there were shepherds out in the fields minding their sheep, minding their own business, and suddenly there was the angel in the sky who caused a great light to shine everywhere, and the shepherds were all a bit gobsmacked and were pretty scared, and the sheep were probably running everywhere. And the angel said, the first thing the angel said was, don't be afraid. So remember, if you feel afraid, that God is right there beside you and he is fully reliable and will always keep his promises. And he promises that when you trust him, you will never, ever be alone. So let's stand up now. And now it's not going to do it. Yes, it is. And we'll share a statement of faith. But I'll just shift these guys over to the side so you can see the board. So let us share a statement of faith. We believe in one God who made and loves all that is. We believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was born, lived, died, and rose again, and is coming to call all to account. We believe in the Holy Spirit, who calls and equips and sends out God's people and brings all things to their true end. This is our faith. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, please sit down again and dive into those goodie bags again. And as Joy reminded us a little while ago, everybody has a piece of white paper. With the white paper, you'll also need a pen, which you should still have in your bag. Okay, we're going to use this as we prepare for our time of prayer. What I want you to do is write on here, there's start of two sentences. I hope something, and I promise I'll try to do something. All right? They're things that you can write. Now, this is for you, just between you and God. During the time of prayer, which is about to come up, once you've written on your sheet of paper, I want you to hold it. I'll put down all my stuff. Hold it in your hands like this during your time of prayer, and you can offer that prayer quietly to God. If you want to, you can say them out loud, but you don't need to. There'll be space for you in the prayer time to do that. So something that you hope, it might be, I hope that I will get lots of Christmas presents. That's not a very good one. I hope that my family will enjoy Christmas. I promise I'll try to be really kind to people this week. Oh, that'd be a hard one for me. All right, so think about that for a minute and just work out what it might be that you hope and what you might promise God to try.
For you have been my hope, O Sovereign Lord, my confidence since my youth. Father, we pray for our world. We praise you that we have our hope in you, our trust in you to have control over this world, to survey it with your love, and to weep over its wickedness. We promise to pray for the leaders of this world, for wisdom in their decision making. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not harm you. Plans to give you hope in a future. floods will be resolved for the good of all. We promise to play our part in looking after this land that you have given us. Faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being certain of what we do not see. Father, we praise you for the certain hope that we have in you. We praise you for the community here at HGK, where we can praise you, worship you, and intercede to you with certainty, with hope, and with confidence. Bless each of us in this community of faith, and strengthen the bonds of your love that tie us together. We promise to nurture and love each other here, to take that love and hope out into our communities. And now, in a time of silence, we pray the prayers we have prepared, or we speak them out. In these Advent days, we rest our hope on the baby in the manger, the one who brings us certainty for our futures.
We are the body of Christ, and the peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us share the peace.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain, our Jesus Christ is born.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have these gifts to share. Accept and use our offerings for your glory and for the service of your kingdom. Amen. And so the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. I think we can do better than that. That was a bit dull. Okay, so let's try again. Lift up your hearts. That's better. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We thank you, gracious God, for these gifts of bread and wine. May we who receive them, as Jesus said, share his body and his blood. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to his friends and said, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He shared the cup with them and said, "This is my blood poured out so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." Fill us with your Spirit that we may follow Jesus in all we do and say, working for justice and bringing your peace to this world that you have made. Be known to us, Lord Jesus, in the breaking of the bread. Amen. This morning, Kate and Richard are going to be our prayer ministers, and they'll pray for you in the far corner.
Made generation.
Living God, in this holy meal, you fill us with new hope. May the power of your love give us courage and bring us to the joys you promise. Amen. Okay. Rightio, a few announcements. This afternoon is our Living Waters service at 4 o'clock with a bring and share dinner afterwards. And this afternoon we'll be looking at soaking in the presence of the Lord. So I received these slides from the email from Bishop Given this last week. This is just something that our money that I took over to Tanzania has actually done for the people over there. That's not all the maize that they bought, but that's Itolwa, where they're doing it quite hard. As you can see, the water is flowing, the grass is growing, and things are looking wonderful. Keep going, ta. And that's where they people come and get a bucket full of maize, and then they take that home and they make their ungali out of it, which is a maize dough, and they make a tomato mixture, and they eat their ungali and their tomato, and that's what sustains them. So this is all out at Itolwa, where they're doing it quite hard. That's some of our, more of our offering and the people there. As you will see, as you see by some of the women that are there, the church gives to Muslims and to Christians. The church makes no distinction between religion. And one of the Muslim ladies said to Bishop Given that this is indeed true religion, when one religion helps the other. So he's just very thankful that we gave that generous offering, and they've been able to feed, as he says, the poorest of the poor. And another thing that we can certainly thank God for is thank you to everyone who prayed for our carols by glow stick night. We actually had 96 people come. So that's worthy of a clap, and certainly very well done, everybody who came. And it was a great night. Okay, so I'm not going to put this little cherub down, so you can bless yourselves. So let's stand. And we say, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. And we're going to have a dance, so I think I might have to put you down.
Oh, you can dance with that.
Can I dance with you?
Yes.
Oh, I don't know.
A familiar song, a familiar artist, and please all join in.
Ain't nothing but a found God for quite a long time. I keep knocking in a found God in spite of all my crime.
Your love has said to me, I pass from death right into life. When it said heaven's automatic, if you place your faith in Christ, you ain't nothing till you found God. Find it while there's time. You keep it knocking till you found God. Christ doesn't hide. When in verse 7 Matthew, you seek and then you find.
Thank you all for coming. Please join us for a cup of tea and yummy stuff to eat at the back of the church.